Science Explorers, it's Justin again. We've been exploring the deep blue ocean, and we've found so many amazing creatures, and some that made us a little nervous. Our time here is almost over, and we're heading back towards the shore, but before we get there, there's one more adventure I've been waiting for. Yes, it's time to step outside this submarine and get even closer. Are you ready to dive in with me? We're about to uncover the vibrant and bustling world of a coral reef. Let's find out what makes these reefs so special before we say goodbye to the ocean. Hey there, explorers! Here we are! Just look at this incredible coral reef. It's kind of like a little underwater city. There's something that makes these reefs very special. The same thing that makes a big city special, actually. It's all about diversity. Biodiversity, that is. Biodiversity means the variety of all the different kinds of life you can find in one area. The more types of creatures, the more biodiversity there is. Just like cities have homes, shops, and parks, reefs provide food, shelter, and places to hide and play for many creatures. They support an amazing level of biodiversity because they're one of the most lively habitats in the ocean. Did you know that even though they cover less than 1% of the ocean floor, coral reefs are home to about a quarter of all marine species out there? Every nook and cranny of a coral reef has life teeming within it. From tiny algae and plankton that feed bigger fish, to predators like sharks that patrol the waters, every creature has a role that helps keep the reef thriving. That's the power of biodiversity. Now that we know what biodiversity is, let's meet some of the residents of this coral city. Ooh, look at this fish. It's called a parrotfish. Parrotfish are amazing helpers in keeping the reef healthy. See how it's eating this stuff off of the reef? They eat the algae that grows on the coral, which is super important. Without parrotfish, the algae could overgrow and suffocate the coral, which would harm the whole reef. And here's a sea turtle. They eat the seagrass, which keeps the beds healthy and stops them from getting too thick. Healthy seagrass beds are vital for many small fish and other creatures that hide and feed there. The parrotfish and sea turtle are vertebrates, like us. Let's look for some invertebrates who live here. Ah, here's one. See this busy little shrimp? They're like the reef's cleanup crew. Shrimp help by eating dead organisms and debris, which keeps the environment clean for everyone. And remember these? The spiky sea urchin also plays a part. Like the parrotfish, sea urchins graze on unwanted algae that can grow over coral, preventing it from receiving the sunlight it needs to thrive. As we've seen, coral reefs are bustling with life, but this part looks different. Maybe it isn't so healthy? Can you see the difference? This part of the reef isn't as colorful. It's actually white. It looks like it's suffering from some serious problems. Mia, what can make a coral reef so sick? Oh no. This type of sickness is often caused by things that humans, like you and me, do? There are several ways humans impact coral reefs. Pollution, like plastic waste, harms the water quality and the marine animals themselves. And overfishing removes too many fish from the environment, which can throw the whole ecosystem off balance. Sad to think that things we do might hurt animals in the ocean, but here's the exciting part. We can all do something to help. What are some things you think we can do to help keep reefs healthy? List two ideas you have in your field notes. Reducing our use of plastic. Supporting seafood that is caught in ways that protect the ocean, and even joining beach cleanups are great ways to start. Oh, hey, there's some helpers cleaning the beach now. Wow, Science explorers, we've learned so much today about the beautiful and delicate world of coral reefs. We discovered the amazing biodiversity they support, understood the vital roles different creatures play, saw how our actions impact these underwater cities, and explored ways we can all help protect them. But our adventure isn't over yet. As the warm breezes of summer begin to cool, I'm getting ready to watch the seasons change. Next, we're heading to the forest to catch the first hints of fall. The wildlife in the forest will be preparing for the colder months. What do you think we'll discover there? Remember, the wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers! Hey, hey.